Welcome to Lucid Mind Chemistry Channel. In this video, I have compiled questions related to the properties of elements of group 7, that is halogens, such as volatility, oxidizing properties, melting points, oxidation reduction reactions, etc. For similar topics and question timestamps, read video description. Question number 35. The element astatine is below iodine in group 17 of the periodic table. Which statement concerning astatine are likely to be correct? Number 1. It is a dark colored solid at room temperature. Yeah, we know for the group 17 that the elements become darker down the group. Number 2. It is a more powerful oxidizing agent than iodine. For halogens, we know that the oxidizing power decreases down the group. So this is not the case. Actually, iodine is more powerful oxidizing agent than astatine. 3. Its hydride is more thermally stable than HBr. Now, stronger the bond between hydrogen and halogen, it will be more thermally stable. So we know that the bond strength decreases down the group. HF has the highest bond strength, then HCl, then HBr, then HI, and astatine is in the last. So it is not more thermally stable, it is actually less thermally stable than HBr. The only option which is correct is 1. So the answer is D. Question 13. Which property explains the trend in volatility of the elements going in group 17? We know that in group 17, volatility basically depends on the intermolecular forces of attraction. And higher the intermolecular forces of attraction, less will be the volatility of elements. In group 17, first we can see there is gas, fluorine is gas, chlorine, bromine is low boiling liquid. Then we have iodine, which is a solid. So the volatility of the elements going down in group decreases. Let's see which options are correct. A. Decreasing covalent bond strength. Now the covalent bond has nothing to do with the volatility of the elements, only intermolecular forces are involved. Decreasing van der Waal forces. Down the group, van der Waal forces actually increase. So this is also wrong. Increasing covalent bond strength, this is nothing to do. And D is increasing van der Waal forces, this is the correct option. So the answer is D. Question 17. Which statement about group 17 elements and their compounds is correct? A. Chlorine reacts with cold concentrated sodium hydroxide to form NaCl and NaClO3. As chlorine in cold alkali forms sodium chloride, sodium chlorate, and water. So therefore A is incorrect. B. HCl is more thermally stable than HBr because chlorine is less electronegative than bromine. As we know that going down in group 7 the electronegativity decreases, so therefore chlorine is more electronegative than bromine. And because of more electronegativity, HCl bond is stronger than HBr, so B is incorrect. C. Iodide ions are oxidized to iodine by concentrated sulfuric acid. Now we know that concentrated sulfuric acid can oxidize bromide and iodide. It cannot oxidize fluoride and chloride ions. With iodide ion, sulfuric acid will form iodine along with sulfur dioxide and water molecule. The oxidation state of iodide has changed from -1 to 0, so therefore this is oxidation. So C seems to be correct. D, silver iodide is soluble in dilute aqueous ammonia. Now silver iodide is soluble in concentrated ammonia, only silver chloride is soluble in dilute aqueous ammonia. So D is also incorrect. The correct option is therefore C. Question 16. Which row correctly describes the properties of halogens as group 17 is descended from chlorine to iodine? First one is volatility and second is the strength as oxidizing agent. Now we know that descending in group 17 we have chlorine, bromine, iodine. As we move from top to bottom, the state changes from gas to solid. It means that the volatility is decreasing. This is because number of electrons increase and interatomic forces of attraction develop. Second is the strength as oxidizing agent. Now oxidizing agent is the one that can easily take electrons, as we know that chlorine is more electronegative than bromine and bromine is more electronegative than iodine. So therefore, strength as oxidizing agent increases upwards. So descending in group 17, the strength of oxidizing agent decreases. The answer is therefore A. Question number 18. Astatine is below iodine in group 17 of the periodic table. Which statement is most likely to be correct? A. Silver acetide reacts with an excess of dilute aqueous ammonia to form a solution of soluble complex. Now this statement is wrong because only silver chloride is dissolved in aqueous ammonia to form a soluble solution. Silver acetide does not dissolve in dilute aqueous ammonia. Astatine and KCl react to form potassium acetide and chlorine. Now, astatine cannot displace chloride ion because astatine is below in the 7 group. So the member below in the series cannot displace the member above it. This is true for halogens. So this is wrong. Actually, chlorine can displace astatine, but astatine cannot displace chlorine. Part C. Potassium acetide and dilute sulfuric acid react to form hydrogen acetide. Now this is also wrong because potassium acetide cannot react with dilute sulfuric acid. Instead, we need concentrated sulfuric acid for this reaction. D. Sodium acetide and concentrated sulfuric acid react to form astatine. Now this is correct. The equation for this chemical reaction would be like this. Sodium acetide plus sulfuric acid, it forms sodium hydrogen sulfate along with hydrogen acetide gas. The hydrogen acetide also reacts with sulfuric acid to form molecule, hydrogen sulfide, and water. So part D seems to be the right answer. Question number 18. Under standard conditions, which statement is correct? So we have to find out the correct statement among these. First is that chlorine aqueous can oxidize bromide ion. Second is reducing. C says chloride ion can oxidize bromine. D says chloride aqueous can reduce bromine. We can write chemical equation for these reactions and we will write NaBr instead of
we are negative. Now the reaction of NaBr with chlorine aqueous. As sodium has positive charge and bromide has negative charge. Now this reaction is possible because chlorine is more reactive than bromine. So it will displace bromine and form NaCl along with bromine aqueous. In this equation, the oxidation state of Br has changed from minus 1 to 0. So from negative 1 to 0 is oxidation. So for part A, chlorine can oxidize Br negative, so this seems to be true. B is chlorine aqueous can reduce Br negative, as Br negative is being oxidized, so therefore this is incorrect. For C, we have chloride ions can oxidize Br2. Let's write a chemical equation for this one. So we can write NaCl instead of chloride as it has negative 1 charge. Plus Br2 aqueous. As we know that bromine is less reactive than chlorine, so it cannot displace this. So therefore the reaction will not occur. So neither oxidation will take place nor reduction. So the correct option is A. Question 16. The volatility of group 17 elements, we have chlorine, bromine, iodine, decreases down the group. What is responsible for this? You should remember that volatility is inversely proportional to intermolecular forces of attraction. And intermolecular forces depend on number of electrons and size of molecule. So as size of molecule increases, number of electron increase, intermolecular forces will increase and volatility will decrease. A, bond length in the halogen molecule. Now bond length does not have anything to do with the volatility, as volatility depends on intermolecular forces, not the bonds. B is bond strength. Again, it does not depend on the bond strength. C, electronegativity of halogen, as similar atoms are present, for example Br2, I2, Cl2, F2. So therefore electronegativity does not have any effect. D is the number of electrons. Now number of electrons increase the intermolecular forces, so therefore the volatility will decrease. The answer is therefore D. Question 14. In this question, X represents an atom of chlorine, bromine or iodine. Which explanation for the variation in volatility down group 17 is correct? As we know that in group 17, what happens that the elements become solid from gas. So therefore, intermolecular forces increase and volatility decrease. A, we have instantaneous dipole, induced dipole forces between molecules become stronger. This is a true statement because the instantaneous dipole and induced dipole forces, they depend on the size of atom. So as we can see that from chlorine to bromine to iodine, the size of molecule increases. So therefore these forces will also increase. And because of these forces, the state will become from gas to liquid and liquid to solid. B, permanent dipole forces between molecules become stronger. This is incorrect because the molecules are made up of similar atoms, so there are no opposite charges present, so permanent dipole forces are absent. Part C, the bond energy of X2 molecule decreases. This is a true statement because the bond energy of fluorine is very high as compared to the bond energy of iodine. But this has nothing to do with the volatility, as volatility does not depend on bond energy, it depends on intermolecular forces. So C is also incorrect. Part D, the first ionization energy decreases. Now the first ionization energy will decrease down the group as the electron is moving farther from the nucleus. So this is also a true statement. But again, it does not have anything to do with the volatility, as volatility depends only on the intermolecular forces of attraction. So D is also incorrect. Correct answer is therefore A. Question 16, which statement about halogens is correct? A. Iodine cannot behave as an oxidizing agent. This is incorrect statement because halogens can gain electron to get itself reduced, and they do behave as oxidizing agents. Part B. The volatility of the elements increases from chlorine to iodine. This is incorrect because volatility decreases because chlorine is gas and iodine is solid. So iodine is less volatile than chlorine. C. When an equimolar mixture of chlorine and hydrogen is exploded, only one product is formed. Let's write the balanced equation. We have 1 mole of hydrogen that reacts with 1 mole of chlorine. It can form 2 moles of HCl. That is the only product that is formed. So C could be correct option. Part D, when concentrated sulfuric acid is added to solid sodium bromide, hydrogen sulfide is one of the products. We can write the chemical equation, sulfuric acid concentrated. It reacts with sodium bromide to form sodium hydrogen sulfate along with hydrogen bromide. HBr can be further oxidized by this concentrated sulfuric acid in a second chemical equation to form bromine, sulfur dioxide, and water. As we can see that in the products formed, no hydrogen sulfide is formed, so therefore D is wrong. Correct answer is therefore C. Question 32. The melting point of chlorine is lower than the melting point of iodine. Which statements help to explain this difference? Now, the melting point depends on the intermolecular forces of attraction, and intermolecular forces is directly proportional to the number of electrons present in the molecule. Option 1. Iodine has more electrons than chlorine. This is true, and so has stronger van der Waal forces. So greater the number of electrons, greater will be the intermolecular forces, or the van der Waal forces. Part 2. An iodine molecule is more polar than a chlorine molecule. This is wrong because iodine molecule is made up of iodine. Electronegativity is same, so therefore no polarity is present. Similarly, chlorine molecule is made up of two chlorine atoms. As electronegativity is same, so therefore no pole is present. Option 3. The covalent bonds between iodine atoms are stronger than the covalent bonds between chlorine atoms. This is wrong because in chlorine, the bond is more strong and more energy is required to break chlorine-chlorine bond as compared to iodine-iodine bond. As only option 1 is correct, the answer is D.
Thanks for watching. If this was useful, please do like, subscribe, and share.